Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video lesson, we are going to learn how we can create stopwatch in C. So let's get started. Double click on Turbo C icon on the desktop to start Turbo C. Turbo C ID is open now. Select new from the file menu to create new source file. Let's start coding. First of all, I am going to include necessary files. Hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h, hash include dos.h, void main, opening brace, closing brace. For this program, we need three variables which controls number of minutes, seconds and hours in our program. So int mm for minutes, ss for second and hh for hours. We are going to initialize all these variables to zero. We can do so in a single statement like this: mm equal to ss equal to ehh equal to zero. In this way, we can initialize multiple variables at one go. Okay. CLRSCR, printf, press enter to continue. Getch. Okay. Now, first of all, we are going to print value of minutes, seconds and hours on the screen. To hide cursor, set cursor type in bracket no cursor. Okay. CLRSCR again. Text mode CAT set the text mode of 80 columns and 25 rows. We are setting the text color say red. Sets red color of the text. This statement sets red color for the text where we use cprintf statement. So go to xy 32, 10, cprintf my stopwatch. Go to xy 37, 12, printf %0 2d, hh. Here percent 0 to D will print 0 before the number, like 08. If we have hours in 2 digits, say 11, it will print 11 only, not 011. Okay. After that, colon must be there. So go to XY 39, 12, printf colon. Now go to XY 40, 12, printf percent 0 to D, comma EMM minutes, prints minutes after colon. Go to XY 42, 12, printf colon prints colon after minutes. Now printing second, so go to XY 43, 12, printf percent 0 to D, comma SS. Okay, so this will print seconds after colon. Before further coding, I am gonna save it. Say swatch.c. Okay, now compile it, run it, but before that I am going to add getch here. Now running the program, say Control F9, pressing enter, and you can see the placeholder for hours, minutes and seconds, and all hours, minutes and seconds are separated by colon. Okay, now we are going to write our main loop. While not kbhit, opening brace, closing brace. Go to XY 43, 12, printf percent 0 to D, comma SS. Okay, this will overwrite the seconds. If SS equal to 60, if 60 seconds then we will increment the value of minutes by 1 and reset seconds to 0. So if yes is equal to 60, mm equal to mm plus 1. Note that we have initialized the value of minutes, seconds and hours to 0 at the beginning. So mm equal to mm plus 1, ss equal to 0, resetting seconds to 0. Go to xy, 40, 12, where we want to print minute, printf percent 0 to d comma mm. Okay, now another if statement. If mm equal to 60, double equal to, if 60 minutes, then we will increment the value of hours by 1 and reset the value of minutes to 0. Okay, so if mm equal to 60, hh equal to hh plus 1, and resetting minutes to 0, so mm equal to 0. Go to xy, 37, 12, the position of hours, printf percent 0 to d comma hh. Closing brace, delay of 1000, delay 1000 indicates delay of 1 second. SS equal to SS plus 1, closing brace of loop, get ch and closing brace. Let's compile it. Okay, no problem is there. So we have finished writing our program. Now we will see how our program works, but before that we are going to execute it. Control F9, pressing enter, and you can see the stopwatch on the screen. I am pressing enter and decrease the value of delay, so we can see how actually it works. So I am changing the delay 1000 to 10. So we can see this process faster. Okay. In this way, this program work. I am correcting it 1000. So let's have a look at the loop. It is indefinite loop. You can come out from the loop by pressing any key from the keyboard. Otherwise, it will execute endlessly. Note that before loop, we have already decided the template for stopwatch, that is where hours are going to print, where minutes are going to print, and where seconds are going to print. So after entering inside the loop, the first printf will overwrite the previous value of seconds, that is 00, with the same value 00 in our case, because the value of seconds is not modified till now. So it will print 00. After that, control moves to first if statement, which checks whether the value of second is 60 or not. This statement. Okay. In our case, the value is 0. So the condition is false. And the control will move to the next if statement here. The condition of this statement, that is if mm equal to 60, is also false. So control moves to this line, delay 1000, delay function, which will produce the delay of 1 second, because 1000 millisecond equal to 1 second. And then the value of SS, that is second, is incremented by 1 after delay of 1 second. So in the next iteration, it will print 1 in second placeholder, and this loop keep on repeating till the value of second is not 60. Note that this stopwatch will print 60 in second column after 59 and not 0. This is really funny, but you can simply avoid this by moving this go to XY and printf after delay 1000 statement, that is here. Now it's okay. When the value of seconds equal to 60, then the value of minute is increased by 1, and the minute placeholder will display 01, and the second placeholder again display 0, because we have reset second to 0 in first if statement. Okay. In this way, when the value of minute is equal to 60, then the value of hours is increased by 1, and then value of minutes is reset to 0. And this process is go on repeating till you do not hit any key from the keyboard. So that's all for today's video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any queries regarding this video, then please let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.